Hello everyone, in this video, you'll learn how to add background music for your video with ActivePresenter. It might be a great way to make your videos more interesting and attracting. However, remember not to play background music if you're recording a narration. They should be added separately so you can edit their volume more precisely. In order to add a music file as background music for your project having multiple slides, firstly, you should select the very first slide because ActivePresenter will play the music file from the slide that you are working on. Okay, go to Open the Annotation tab. Then click the audio icon. ActivePresenter provides you two options to add background music, which are importing existing file from your computer or creating a new one. At first, I will explain to you how to use an existing audio file as background music. Click from File. ActivePresenter will lead you to the file location in your computer. Just choose the audio file that you like, then click Open, and it will be added automatically into the slide that you are working with. You can change its volume by clicking the Adjust Volume icon and scale it the way you want. However, you should scale it much lower than your narration voice volume, if any. Now the audio file is shown in the first slide only. You have to let it play through all other slides. To do that, right-click the audio object either on the timeline or on the canvas, then select Play over multiple slides. Unlike adding a logo or image, for an audio file, you can choose either top or bottom layer because they have the same result. After adding background music, a chance is that your music file duration is shorter than your project duration. To make it play to the end of the project, go to Audio Session in the Properties pane and check the loop checkbox in the playing options. That means that ActivePresenter will replay the music file when it comes to the end. If you select Ignore Pausing checkbox, ActivePresenter will continue to play the background music while the presentation is paused to wait for user inputs. So, as you can see, the audio file now stretches from the first to the last slide. Let's see. There's a very short stop moment between two slides, but don't worry because it will disappear after you export your project. Now, what if you want to use another audio file as your background music? Go to select the audio file. Then, in the audio section, in the properties pane, choose either select an audio from the library or import an audio file from your computer. The new audio file will automatically replace the old one. Now comes the second way, which is creating a new audio file as background music. On the Annotation tab, under the audio icon, select Create New. The audio section in the Properties pane allows you to import an audio file from the library or from your computer. Or you can record your voice to use as background music under the recording section. Just choose Input Device and click the Record button to start recording. Then you will have an audio file that can be previewed in this session. All the following steps are the same to those in the first way. Now, just in case you don't want to have any background music for your video anymore, just delete it. Select audio file and press Delete key on your keyboard. Finally, let's mix around your project with background music to video so you can see how it works. So, I hope it helps you to add any favorite piece of music as background music for your videos. Thank you for watching.